and help us out to what's available for $7, I believe. So we'd love to support the center and go over there for lunch. But I also want to tell you a little bit more about Stone Society before I introduce Mitch. And I want to tell you some of the upcoming events. Wednesday, March 21st, we are going to do something really new. We're going to have a Get to Know You with the Family Heirloom ability. So an heirloom or an antique, bring it in, give us some insight into what you're about, and let us get to know you a little bit better. Because we all come to these meetings and, yeah, we recognize faces after a while, but we don't really know each other all that well. So wouldn't it be great to get to know a little bit more about each other? And people have asked for that, so this is what we're going to do. And we're also going to have an antique appraiser talk a little bit about the antique appraiser process. So that'll be interesting as well. On Friday, the 21st, some of you were here when we had a coffee and conversation slideshow in September when Ronnie and John talked about Africa. Well, there was such a hue and cry for a second showing of that, that we decided to make it an after work event on a Friday evening. We're going to have that slideshow again, and we're going to have African music, a band that's going to play African drums, and also we're going to try and do some African food. So come have Exploring Africa Night with us on April 21st, Friday. And then, as a lot of you know, we do Mother's Day cheese this Saturday before Mother's Day. That this year is May 12th, and of course, everybody's welcome to attend. And of course, we sell out every year, so if you're interested, sign up soon. And then a new event that we're starting to plan is what we're calling Men on Fire for the Arts. And what we try to do is find some able and willing men who are going to give us samples of their culinary skills at Weaver Park. We'll have music, we'll have games, we'll have all kinds of fun. So that's coming up on Saturday, October 6th in the late afternoon. So stay tuned for more about that. That's going to be a lot of fun. Now, let me tell you a little bit about Mitch. First of all, I know Mitch, because I've taken classes with Mitch. I think he's a great teacher. So when I heard he was talking today, I got really excited. I said, I got to come in with him. So Johanna said, that's a great idea. Why don't you do that? So here I am, and here Mitch is. And Mitch is going to tell you a lot about himself. But let me tell you that he has painted in many, many places and done a lot of sculpture in many places. One of the things on the bio and in the paper is that he does the cross for the Greek Orthodox celebration of January, which of course we all know about every year. And one of the things that I find extremely exciting is some of the fresco work that he's done in the Disney places in Orlando. Yeah. He's not going to let you see any of that today, but come back another time for that, because that's really cool. We'll take one of his classes and get to know more about it. But anyway, today he's going to talk to us about sculpture and plein air. And stay tuned, because I think you're all going to love it.
Thank you, Candy, for that introduction, and thank you all for coming today. Thanks to the Sterling Society for putting this on. Hope everybody enjoys some coffee back here. And, they asked me to do the coffee conversations today, so I said, well, what do I want to talk about? And I was kind of torn between two of my passions, so I said, I'm just going to talk about both of them. So I'm going to cram a lot into an hour, and the way to expedite that, I think I made a documentary about this sculpture right here. This is called Get Behind, and it is it's about the history of the Cracker Cowman in the state of Florida. And rather than sit here and talk all about it and everything, I got a documentary that's about 20 minutes long that will explain the whole process from start to finish. And educate you about the lost wax process, which is the process that's needed to produce a sculpture into bronze. I also teach a class at Dunedin on Tuesday evenings from 6:30 to 9:30 about the human anatomy and the figurative sculpture. So I've got a piece over here I'll show you after the film. And then I'm going to launch into plein air painting, which is my next passion. And I hope to get a plein air class started if we get enough students together. Maybe we did the cottage and just kind of go out in the air and paint. And I'm teaching a workshop next Saturday. And so I still have openings for that. If anybody's interested, I've got information about that workshop. And then right now, let me just pass out this. Just take one and pass it down. Tell us a little bit about myself. Take this. This is about plein air painting.